story once instead of to multiple different people. And I think, you know, we've built together, and the fact that we've celebrated the year in culture and the year in the environment, we hope really that they'll have lasting legacies and help people grow to be healthier and more resilient in the long term. But thank you for your leadership, because you've allowed us to think differently.
Thank you for your kind words, Chris. I appreciate that. Okay, last but by no means least,
thank you, Phil. I've never, in all my years on this council, dealt with anything but austerity. And frankly, I'm completely sick of it. Every year, we seem to be handed an axe by central government, and it's all worth it. And every year, if your leadership, Phil, we've managed not to close a single service. And I think it's remarkable. I look at colleagues across the country and other councils, many of which have not been hard hit nearly as much as us, and they've been far worse. And I think they wish they had you. At a time of unprecedented need, with having an unprecedented amount of taking in funds, I've got to go on record my thanks to all the staff, trade unions, clubs and volunteers who at a time when we're getting most taken from us have never failed to give me. Through careful income generation and budget management, we're opposing investing in our leisure and recreational services. Through tough decisions, we're going to secure the future of our golf and for all the I know it's been difficult, but it seems a remarkable achievement. And genuinely, I don't think if we were anything other than the Labour Council, we wouldn't be having this discussion today. This budget proposes to ensure our services continue to go from strength to strength, Phil, and I think it's a credit to your leadership. And I will certainly be supporting this proposal.
Okay, thanks, Phil. And thank you for everybody for all your kind words, but you know the focus is on the residents of Wirral, and I think focuses on the residents of Wirral, and I think we've done that through this budget. Right, before I move the recommendation of item 6, I'm just going to ask Bernie Mooney to just say a few words. Bernie, if you wouldn't mind about the school's budget, that's okay.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so
we're
all proud, actually, of the way the school's doing
around
the world. We have some
excellent
schools.
Bernie, put your microphone on.
Oh, sorry. Just to repeat, I was just saying how proud we are of the schools here on the Wirral and the work that the schools do. They do this under very testing circumstances. And they continue to go beyond what's required of them in supporting our children and helping our children to reach their aspirations. It's never easy to determine the school's budget, particularly when central government impose new formulas and new cuts, and with no knowledge or consideration of what the problems are here, it's done in a very arbitrary way down in London, and we see the results of that in places like housing, and that, you know, some person sitting in London making decisions about what's happening up here on the road, and it doesn't actually reflect what's needed. This school budget has been developed through extensive consultations with our schools forum, and we thank the schools forum for all their input and for their constructive comments. This report sets out the school budget for 2019-2020, having been previously considered by the school forum for election on January 16, 2019. So the school budget covers education provision for all Wirral pupils aged up to 18 in early years, primary, secondary and academy schools, and for some pupils up to the age of 25 in special schools and high need providers. This budget also delegates to schools with some central provision for support services, including schools admission and high needs. The report proposes a number of changes to local funding formula in schools to allow the transition formula for the national funding formula. There are also changes proposed to high needs. The school budget provides resources to support all children and young people and for that pledge. And the proposals will result, believe it or not, this year in a cut in deficit, so we're starting from a deficit of £2,343,000 £2,343,200 to the dedicated schools grant. So schools are already starting this year in deficit. It's unbelievable really, isn't it? But Cabinet recommends that the 2019 and 2020 schools budgets of an eye-watering £267,661,400 to Budget Council, taking into account the view of the formula proposals from the schools forum. And the recommendations of this four of them. Before we go into that, I think it's about time we started challenging the government a little bit more on this, and I would like to recommend some form of motion. I'd like to recommend a couple of things. I'd like to recommend that a motion comes from us to go to central government, and I'd like to recommend that, we already worked with Brad Cushing, who's the chair of the Children and Families Portfolios holders for the whole of the North West. We lobbied in 23% and sent a letter to government, which was sort of just backheeled, and they sent us a very polite letter back saying that we're not going to give you any more funding. But I'm suggesting two things. I'm suggesting a motion, first of all, from here, and also that I write about again, and then we do it on a city region level, because I think the lack of funding in children's services is just criminal, really, some of the stuff that's going on. And the recommendation I have here is the council, Wirral Council have already put an extra £20 million into children's services, and we can see the difference that that has made to the service that we can provide to children. This approach needs to be moved into the schools' funding formula. We need to have more money given to council, to schools. So we call upon the government to stop cutting the dedicated schools grant and to start funding children's services in Wirral appropriately. We ask for this to be done before the national funding formula starts next year. So if everybody's happy for me to move that, I can do some.
Bernie, can I just make it? Sorry, just whispering in with Vicky. I think that's a really, really good idea. I think we should be lobbying government for extra funding for schools. Can I suggest that we add that to the recommendations in the school budget to go forward to Budget Council on the 4th of March?
I'm happy to
And then you can supply Patrick with a copy of the lobbying, but we get a gist of it, of what's being proposed.
Seacombe, which is the only authorities that put in our side of London metropolitan border, and also the LGA. Because I think what you just said there is something that needs to be emphasised regularly across the whole country. Because it is a massive effect, it's having a massive effect on the internal children. And it's a good one to come from London.
Yeah, I know the LGA,
sorry,
I know the LGA
Have
put in their own lobbying. Very public. The LGA is saying that children's services is £2 billion short to meet, and because of austerity and because of everything else that this government is doing, we're having more and more children, more families are in crisis, and we're having more children to look after. So they may be saving money up top, but it's costing us a lot more money down here. So the LGA are already doing something, but I'm more than happy to have everybody come in on this, because I think it's about time we started screaming and shouting from the rafters about this. Anita, sorry.
Yeah, sorry, Anita.
Thanks, Chair. Obviously, the government has been telling us that early intervention is really important. And, you know, I wouldn't like to miss our nursery schools out of this ocean as well, because, you know, it's extremely important that they are our early intervention.
This motion is generally about school funding, but I think we need to do something about funding for all children as well. So I think there's two things to do, but I agree with you.
handle, not only the actual the fact that the fund has been cut, the fact that the funds have shambles under the radar, shows that the effects of reducing funding on our schools, as well as reducing funding. The government wants to fund refugee schools, even though it's a service places in the particular areas, which just exacerbates the problem for existing schools. As politicians and as school governors, we're regularly tasked with dealing with financial shortfalls. But I think what we should lose sight of is that not only are government robbing us of funding, but also robbing our people of their futures, which I think is even more scandalous. And I think anyone in the Conservative Party who supports that policy should be able to shame themselves. And sorry, I want to just have it. There's a really useful resource. I recommend everyone to have a look at schoolcuts.org. It's basically you can drill down to locally what school, how we all local schools being affected by the funding cuts and how many teachers and teacher assistants and other friends. And it's quite telling that James Cleverly has written to the people behind schoolcuts.org website asking them to take offline.
I put that on to the recommendations now, but just to add to what Stuart has just said and just to add to the concerns of all of us, it's amazing how many schools now are providing breakfast for children with children returning up home. So that's another bit of funding that schools have got to find, that they've got to feed their children before they start. How on earth can we be the fifth or the sixth richest country in the world and we're sending our children to school hungry? I just can't believe it. But anyway, back to school funding, we'll put that extra one on. So the recommendations are that the 2019-2020 school funding formula should be transition formula, introducing some elements of the national funding formula, including the minimum per pupil funding formula levels of 3,500 for primary schools and 4,800 for secondary schools. That the minimum funding guarantee of 0% for Wirral schools for 2019-2020 is approved and provides additional protection and stability in funding, and to ensure that no school can lose pupil funding unless there is a reduction in the pupil numbers, ensuring that no pupil is disadvantaged as a result.